when you really follow him, you can expect life to get better, you know? And just thinking about my birthday, you know, when I look over 56 years, God has been faithful every year. He's been faithful at every stage of my life, just because I said yes to follow him. You know what I'm saying? You can't do his will and your will. You have to say yes to his will. And when you say yes to his will, he's obligated to show up. So you can expect life to get better, you know? I'm never depressed on a birthday. I get excited because, like, it's got to get better. It's gonna be better than what it was last year, you know? Yeah, you can expect to get better. He's a good shepherd. He's a good shepherd. He's a good shepherd. Throughout my career, I have never done a live recording. And it wasn't a strategy or anything. It's not like I was trying to stay away from it, but I just never had it in my plans to do.
When we first signed CeCe, it was probably the first thing that came to mind. And in our first discussions, and as we started talking about what would the next project be, Chaz and I were talking, we said, man, it'd be awesome if we could just get you doing a live worship record.
I felt like it was something that I should do and decided to take on the challenge.
Man.
Okay, yeah. We pieced it together pretty good. Thank you, Lord. Okay. All right, let's fix a few things. A few more things.
So verse two.
When I was invited to produce this album for CeCe, I was obviously totally blown away. The first meeting that we had to talk about the record, we met at CeCe's house, and I looked at CeCe and I said, your entire life experience and everything that God has taken you through and that you've taken us through along with you, along the journey, it has built up this authority. You've been places with God that most of us have not been, in music and in life. And that really is what working with CeCe has been like. It is just this authority that exists, and we all draft off of it ultimately. And she leads, again, she leads and walks in that authority with incredible humility.
Move the immovable, break the unbreakable. God, we believe for it. From the impossible, we'll see a miracle. God, we believe. Yes, we do. God, we believe for it.
We had a couple of meetings and Dewan was there, and I can't explain it. I had never done this before, but I just knew within a couple of conversations with Dewan and Dewan being at that table that he needed to stay at the table.
When I heard that Kyle had met with Dewan Hill and invited him to co-produce this record, my comfort level and my respect for Kyle went way up.
As we prepared for the record, we realized that one of the most important aspects of the record was the people on stage with her. And we did not want to bring in people that she didn't feel comfortable with, both from a spiritual level, but also from a musical level.
Hey guys, how you guys doing? You all right?
We're good, how are you?
I'm good. Wow, we are about to do our first live record. Can y'all believe it? We're gonna get some other singers here. Okay. Give me one of the most important things we need to have.
What sticks out now is however many singers you're getting, you have to make sure that you work with them and seeing that they have the ability to be flexible. Meaning,
okay,
when we rehearse, that's one thing. Mm-hmm. Like if you say, hey, in rehearsal we did the chorus twice.
Yeah.
But when we get on stage and you flip it and we don't do that, and you go in a whole nother direction that even the singers, and I've been with you for a long time, you still surprise me on stage with coming up with new things that we've never done before.
Okay.
So it's very important that you can be flexible and you know how to make sense and still be a help in that situation when you call for it.
Wow. Because that's pretty amazing how you guys always sing with such freedom and such enthusiasm. And but yet you're following me. It's like you're watching me. And that's
every word.
Yeah. And because it's like I know you're going to be there. I feel your support. You've been with me long enough to know you feel it coming, and you guys are right there with me, you know. So Christy, tell me, what do you think? That give me one thing that's good for what we should look out for the singers.
I would say one major thing to look for, we're looking for singers, are singers who can sing multiple parts.
Okay.
And I say that because, you know, as a singer, you can have a bad day out of nowhere.
Yeah.
And you're not planning on it. It just happens sometimes.
Yeah. Yeah.
So if you have singers who can sing multiple parts, then you'll be covered regardless.
That's good. That's good.
Picking those singers that had the heart of worship and also the skill of worship was crucial. And so my wonderful friend, Calvin Nowell, who's known all over the world for worshiping and being a blessing to so many people, he went out and he knew, he connected the people who he knew would connect with this project. Their hearts were already there. And I felt that.
I've actually admired every last one of these singers from afar. I've watched them, and I've always wondered what it'll be like to sing with them. And to find myself, little old me, in the midst of all this greatness was unbelievable.
The first rehearsal was at CeCe's house. First of all, I was nervous. I'm like, this is the first time that I'm actually going into her home, and the first time with everyone. But it was an amazing experience, absolutely. It was like we became family. Even from the first rehearsal, you could feel the love, the warmth from everyone, and it was just absolutely amazing.
I talked to Dewan, who was the co-producer, and he was saying, yes, we want singers that are talented, great heart, but they also have to have the sensibility to flow. And what I mean by that is CeCe will go in and out of a song, so we needed singers that had the ability to flow spontaneously, but also we didn't need the arrogance.
The best part of the show is in the stuff that's not planned. And so it's almost like we give a softball pitch to her and we say, this is what we're doing. She offers that to God, and what God responds with, which is, he responds with things we've never done before. Every rehearsal we've done so far has been a new vamp and a new melody and a new way of singing the same song. And that's inspiring. You know, it's inspiring to me as a music director and producer, but it's also inspiring for the audience to know that God is still downloading fresh material by the day.
Vamps, you know, when I think about the Winans, the Winans was, they're still my one of my favorite groups. You know, they're my favorite group. I just have to say that. My brothers are a little bit older than me, and I used to go to their concerts. And my brother Marvin, we used to call him Vampire because every song had a vamp, you know? And we just grew up with that. We grew up with that. And people might be saying, what is that? What is a vamp? Well, you sing the song, and then you kind of just sit there a minute and say, okay, what else can this song do? You know, Lord, what are you saying here? And I grew up in that. And so I do that a lot. Because sometimes you're singing something, the Holy Spirit will give you a thought, and it's like, oh, you got to go with the wind. I was taught, you got to follow the wind. And the wind might go somewhere totally different than what you planned, but when you do it, God shows up in a new way.
Sometimes in worship settings, you just have to declare a thing over and over and over again. And CeCe is so fun and so musical. You do it in ways that you don't even realize you've spent 15 minutes on a song. And the presence of God just gets thicker and thicker in moments like that. I love it.
With this recording, I realized it doesn't take a lot. She didn't have to oversing. She didn't have to do a lot of ad-libbing. She just knew how to usher in his presence by really getting out the way.
CeCe Winans was made for this. She's shown us through decades what she's capable of. And the touch of God has been evident from the beginning. But she's been an artist, and we celebrate that. But this is why she's on the planet. She's marked for this.
If you follow my career at all, you'll see a diverse collection of different styles of music, different genres, you know, because I love it all. I love the contemporary. I love the R&B feel. I love the praise and worship. But my favorite place, my assignment, is worship.
So being here is like very full circle for me. My mom listened to CeCe as a teenager, and I found out through him that she was cutting hunger, and it was just like, it's kind of surreal, and watching her sing it, hearing her sing it is very surreal. I've never heard anyone sing one of my songs before, and it's like, it feels like a great beginning, and I am very blessed and excited and happy and grateful that I got to experience this.
So I wasn't trying to do this song so that I could do it better, because I know I can. But I was doing it because I want people to experience the anointing that's in the song. Every time we sing this song at National Life at my church, we're in the floor. We're worshiping and we're crying. And I'm a worshiper. But I want you to know that God has used you to take my worship to another level. And I know you sing this in a higher key, but if you can you go to her key real quick? There's no way I want you here and not here a little bit. Okay? So this might be a part of the tape, and it might not be, but y'all are in for sure. Just sing a little bit for me. I'm a firm believer that when it ministers to my heart, then I'm able to minister to other people. When something takes me all the way to the King, you know what I'm saying? Then I get excited about ministering that to other people. And so I just applaud this young lady. I'm so excited what God has given her and what He's doing in her. And I'm excited about watching how far she'll go.
There was a moment after the recording where we got to share with CeCe what she meant and what she means to us. Each singer got to share their story, and each story was different, but the common thread was that CeCe was pivotal for every single singer, for each singer, getting us through each season to this moment.
I never saw myself singing like this at all, but I'm grateful that you gave me a chance. even when I didn't see anything in me. And so I just want to say thank you.
This has really, you don't know how this has ministered to me in this season that I'm in right now. Just the things you've said and just the work, just your worship has just so, I've literally left like our rehearsals and just said, thank you, Lord, for like just ministering to me.
And so he doesn't just show up for me, he shows up because all of us are there.
Yeah.
Asking for this to happen, for people to hear it. And that's why I know people are going to be blessed, they're going to be healed, they're going to be delivered, they're going to be set free, because it was just him. Hmm. You know? And then we get back and realize recording is better than what? Kyle was like, I've never been a recording that's better than what it was.
Yeah, it was.
You worry about capturing what you have, and that's when you just sit back and say, Lord, you are doing this.
I walked away from that recording really, really believing God for greater.
We have to believe that God is not only able, but he's willing to show up in the deepest, darkest places of our lives.
Because we're in a tough spot right now. We're going through some rough things that we've never been through before. And it's a time that you really have to know that you believe.
Like, there's a part of our faith that just goes beyond science or reason or understanding, that he is the God who makes miracles and he is the one who moves mountains, and with him in his time, all things are possible. So I'm just gonna believe.
We're just in that time that we cannot back up. We have to stand and believe for it. And so, yes, I'm believing for some real miracles to happen. And I'm not gonna wait till I see it. I'm praising them now. Action tonight. I am so full because the presence of the Lord was here. And we ended tonight really on a note that everything else is built on, and that is we love Jesus. We're so grateful the people came, the power of God showed up, and I just know that miracles happen. So I am so glad for his grace and his glory. God is good. Great night. He's still working.